Hello and welcome to the episode 142 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we witness the Beatles becoming the de facto headliners of their third package tour, the recording of a piano part for You Can't Do That, and the first public appearance of John Lennon and Yoko Ono as a couple. On the 22nd of May 1961, as usual, the Beatles were busy with their second Hamburg residency. The lads, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Top 10 Club throughout the night. Almost all the same in 1962, another residency in Hamburg, this time at the Star Club, now approaching its end. In 1963, the Roy Orbison package tour resumed after a day of rest, with a concert at the Gaumont Cinema in Ipswich. This was the first date of the tour in which, by popular demand, the Beatles performed last, closing the event. In 1964, with the Beatles on holiday in Tahiti or Virgin Islands, producer George Martin decided to add a piano track to You Can't Do That. The work was conducted by Martin and his staff in the Abbey Road EMI studios between 10 and 11 a.m. The overdub was added to take 9, creating take 10, but was unused for the continuation of the work on the song. And here's where I hold the presses to tell you about the breaking news. You can show up how fab you are by contributing to the success of this very podcast. How? Why, check out www.simonmas.com/support to find out all the many ways, but here's a couple. Share this episode, or your favorite one, on your social media. Send me any donation via PayPal. Send me comments about what you like the most and why you keep on following this series. Feeling fab yet? No? Well, time to act and make the difference then. Thank you. On the 22nd of May 1968, 3 days after the start of their relationship, John Lennon and Yoko Ono appeared in public for the first time. The excuse was the lunchtime launch party for Apple Tailoring, civil and theatrical, one of the new business ventures of the Beatles. George Harrison and his wife Patty were also present at the event, which opened with a short press conference. Finally, in 1969, the Queen Elizabeth II finally arrived to New York City with Ringo Starr, Peter Sellers, their partners, and other members of the production crew of The Magic Christian. If you're wondering what this is all about, you need to check episode 122 of What a Fab Day. Once the crossing of the Atlantic had been completed, everyone flew to the Bahamas for a 2-week holiday in the sun. This concludes today's episode. Tomorrow we'll have a car crash. Tune in to see who will be injured. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.